Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I know.
My name is Ariana, and I am the favorite cousin of Coop. I just had to make that clear early on. I'm going to be the mistress of ceremonies for this evening. So at this time, it is my pleasure. While he's queuing up the song, thank you all for coming out tonight. We know the weather was kind of iffy, but we're just grateful that you all came out tonight to celebrate a great person, a great man of God, and just an amazing, amazing person. And we're thankful that you came out to celebrate his life on this night. So thank you. So at this time, we're going to introduce the guest of honor, Mr. Kerwan Cooper. So we'll leave it up to the waiters here as far as instruction to serve the tables. So everyone just pay attention accordingly. Thank
you. 12.
It's 12. Everybody knows it's 12. So, number two, we got what is Coop's favorite burger of all time?
Wild Burger,
the Baconator, the Big Mac, or Five Guys? It's the Baconator.
Thank you.
Baconator, Wendy.
Number three.
Yes.
Which one did you do? Hit 5 home runs in a softball game, score 40 points in a game, beat someone 98-3 in Madden football.
Oh my goodness!
Drove a car at 2 years old, jumped out of a window because he could make the work.
I know somebody that did do that.
Making a play right now. Which one of these restaurants would Coop say is overrated? Chick-fil-A, Greek Chris, Olive Garden, Chipotle, and Red Rocket?
Chipotle.
Yes, it's crazy!
It's true. Hey,
everybody makes mistakes.
Everybody makes mistakes.
Number 5. At what school did Coop attend kindergarten? Randallstown Elementary, Galloway Elementary. He did 10
kindergarten.
Galloway! Oak Avenue, no, it's
I told you it was Cali.
DJ. Yeah. Let you keep DJ.
Bring in order. Who's favorite basketball players of all time?
Got it.
Who's number one?
Himself.
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 Dirk.
Leave a homie better than Coop.
Pick the company that Coopers didn't do a commercial for. That the Coopers did not do a commercial for. Burlington, Giant, Sprout, Chuck E. Cheese, Johnson & Johnson, BWI Airport, or YMCA. Chuck E. Cheese.
Edward Cheese.
Junior.
Number nine. What nickname did Coop have? Did Coop hate having?
Cece.
I remember him being called
Poco.
Poco.
Oh, his nickname now is Poco.
Yeah, Poco.
What was Coop's worst work basketball team name?
They're actually saying it right.
They know him, but
Cartier.
Cartier.
There you go.
He did it earlier. You gotta show me.
They want you to demonstrate.
Yeah, they want to see the dance.
Huh? They wanted you to demonstrate the dance.
They want me to do it?
Yeah, exactly.
That's what somebody said. Can he do it?
Yeah.
All right, so So I'm gonna kick off this roast with toast. So I think perfect.
So, what was that?
Happy birthday to my cousin. He's more like a brother to me. We grew up together, played basketball out in my grandma's backyard, and just everything that he's been there for me for, and just, happy birthday to you. I love you, and I'm proud of you. I'll kick off the roast. I guess we'll see quick stories. The first one, some of y'all know, Siobhan, you definitely know this one. It was the infamous bike ride from my grandmother's house to some of y'all know where Kid City used to be on Liberty Road. We took a bike ride out there almost, 25 years ago now?
Yes.
And the story has kind of changed a lot over what actually happened during that excursion between me and him. We had one bike between the two of us. That bike was his, was C's bike. The bike had a partially flat tire. And we went out to kick to Libby Road. I don't know what we were doing out there.
It was a dare.
Okay, it was a dare. That's what she said. And on our way back, we realized that we might be in trouble. We were gone all day. And I was, maybe 8?
Yes.
And you were 13. So this is a bike ride from my grandmother's house. For those of y'all don't know, it's Wabash and
Garrison.
Garrison. It's a little ride. We got back, we realized we were in trouble. We seen both of our mothers home a little bit early from work, because they realized we were probably somewhere we shouldn't have been. And he said to me, let's just tell them that we were at Leroy's house.
Oh, no. five little things
all day. So I said, okay, cool, that's what we do. So we do that, and then our parents are like, no, I know y'all weren't there. We checked with Leroy. I'm like, no, that's where we were. See, that's where we were. So he told me to tell y'all. So that's where we were. And so afterwards, at some point, he said, look, my mom was like, look, see, I already told Aunt Sharon where y'all were, and why don't you just tell me the truth? And I'm like, why would she do that? He told me to say the truth. He's like, why would he tell him the truth? Why would he dime me out like that? So I'm like, all right, well. No, we were at Leroy's house, and I stuck with it at first, and she's like, Eric, I don't know why you the only one still lying about the story. And I'm like, all right, we got to do damage control now. Okay, so we took a little ride somewhere else, we went somewhere else, and she's like, okay, thank you. And we both got spankings, and to this day, C says that he never told the truth about the story. And that our moms pulled the wall off the apartment. I refuse to believe that. To this day, C told the truth. I had to bear the brunt of that because I kept lying. C told the truth. That's one quick story. The second